We have a saying here in China. Shanghai, 就像一个美女。Seductive, mysterious, and these days, very attractive to foreign businessmen. Executives, bankers, engineers, salesmen. Hundreds of thousands of Americans now live and work in Shanghai. This is the story of one American named Sam. A good man, easy to get along with, never arrogant or cocky. And because of this, he was loved by everyone he met in Shanghai. Or maybe not. Sam just won the most important court case of his life. His bosses have called him into a meeting. Sam Chow is on his way to the top.
And after poaching the client from a senior associate, no less. Ballsy!
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The reason why we asked you here, Sam, we've got some exciting news for you. We're sending you to China.
Sorry.
Groff Technologies has just moved its headquarters to Shanghai. Where it is, they're on to something big.
A game changer.
If our top client goes to Shanghai, that means we go too.
We've been in touch with Donald Cafferty from AmCham, the American Chamber of Commerce there. He's found us an office and hired us a local staff. Now all we need is someone to head it up. You're the obvious choice. You're single, you're a go-getter, and you're even Chinese.
Technically, yes. Chinese. Isn't there something else you guys wanted to say to me?
We're aware of the rumors. We're just not ready to name a partner just yet.
But we are ready to send you to China. This is a huge opportunity, Sam.
It's an incredibly tempting offer. But I just feel that I'm more of an asset here in New York. I mean, I know the ins and outs. I know everything. And my 30th birthday is coming up. I've rented out Thomas Keller's restaurant. I got a DJ coming. I got a lot of stuff going on.
You know what we like around here, Sam? A team player. 3 months. That's all we ask. What do you say?
That's me.
Welcome to China. Amanda Wilson, relocation specialist. It's my job to help you get adjusted.
Hi.
For a second, I thought I missed you. I was running late. My IE was sick, and I had to find a babysitter. And so, everything okay?
Yeah, I was just expecting someone with slightly darker hair. Oh.
Here's your survival pack, some Chinese yuan, money, in other words, a map of Shanghai, your business cards, and your mobile phone, your numbers, right on the back. So before we go to your apartment, I want to take you to meet Donald from AmCham. He's kind of the mayor of Americatown.
Americatown?
Yeah, it's what we call our little expat community over here. It's kind of like Chinatown in the U.S., but the other way around.
Ah.
Here you go. 我们去浦西花海路.
Ah. Speak Chinese?
Of course. Don't you?
Thank you.
Restaurant opening.
Oh, yeah? I love a good restaurant. What kind of food do they have?
Donald! Amanda! Good morning. Well, this must be Sam. Donald Cafferty, president of JFC China.
Sam Chow. Nice to meet you. Never seen so much fanfare at a fast food place before.
Our 8,000th store opening called for a little celebration. The Chinese are crazy about fried chicken. Here, have a coupon for a free spicy chicken sandwich. Welcome to Shanghai. What are you doing Thursday night? Great. Meet me for drinks out on the bund. I'll introduce you to all the top business execs in town. Microsoft, P&G, Ford. I'm gonna drive a lot of business your way. Ever been to China before?
I've never been above 79th Street before. New York Street. Joke.
He's gonna be a homesick one, I can tell. Well, lucky for you, I own an American bar in Hongqiao. If you ever get lonely, come on by.
Okay, sounds great.
Good okay. Man. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm late for my photo shoot.
Modeling career finally taking off?
No, AmCham election's coming up. See you Thursday, Sam.
Yeah. Thursday.
So, ready to see your new apartment?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Sorry?
Look, I had a nice life back in New York. So whatever you found me, better not be too much of a letdown.
Okay, here we are. Two bed, two bath. Hardwood floors, recycled glass windows, high-def TV, solar panels on the roof, and the entire building is brand new. What do you think?
That's awesome. I'll take it.
Okay, I'll get the papers ready.
What the hell was that?
Construction, but they're supposed to be finished by now.
Are you telling me this building is still being built?
Shanghai and construction go hand in hand, and sometimes these new, greener buildings take just a little bit longer to get...
Oh.
Okay, I have to get you out of here. I have a backup apartment down the street. It's not as nice as this one, but at least it's finished.
Is it a dump?
No, I mean, it's a tad smaller and the amenities are less new, but it's a really nice place in a great neighborhood.
It's a dump. I'm staying here. Forget about it.
Sam, I cannot in good conscience let you stay here with all that noise going on upstairs.
I completely agree. So here's what you do. Just tell them the future partner of a huge American law firm just moved in. They need to shut it down for 3 months or else I'll sue them. Here's my card.
Right, this may not work.
Amy?
Amanda.
Your job was to find me a nice, quiet place to live, and you failed. Now, are you going to resolve this issue, or do I need to replace you?
It's you.
This is Sam.
Hello, Mr. Chow. This is Feng Feng, your new assistant. I hope you had a good flight. Are you planning to attend the Marcus Groff meeting today?
Today? No. I thought the meeting was tomorrow, the 17th.
Yes, but today is the 17th.
That's impossible. I left New York on the 15th. I lost one day by crossing over the date line. That makes today the 16th.
Actually, you lost 2 days. It became the 16th in the U.S. while you were in the air. When you crossed the date line, it became the 17th. And Mr. Groff will be here in 30 minutes.
I'll be right there.
I heard. You know what? You get to your office, and I will go upstairs and see what I can do about that construction issue.
I got nothing. I don't speak Chinese. Who are you?
Oh, 你不会说中文，你是老外是不是啊？ Oh, 我是你的阿姨，阿姨，阿姨。
Hey, Amanda, so that's it. Are you my nanny? You're like a housekeeper. You clean. Housekeeper.
Sleep? What?
You live here. You live with me. You live with me, my housekeeper, and you don't speak English. Habla español. That was really offensive on many, many levels. I'm sorry about that, but I have to go. I'll see you later. Okay, this is Ying Cheng Road. Okay, that's gotta be. You have no idea. Which means, let's go ahead.
Taxi!
Hi. Can you take me to this address, please?
要到的这个地方，就在那儿。Just
take me to the address.
你不需要坐出租车，走过去就行了。
Why are we arguing?
看见了吗？前面的大楼就是你要去的地方。Oh,
okay. All right. I get it. I'm from New York City, so don't think that just because I'm from out of town that you can pad the fare by going the long way or whatever it is you're trying to do. Just take me here. Thank you.
Mr. Chow, we spoke on the phone. I'm Fang Fang, your assistant.
Wow, Fang Fang, thank you for calling. Is he here?
Yes, in the conference room. Marcus Groff from Groff Technology in San Antonio.
San Antonio. Thank you. Yeah, let's see, Alamo,
what are you writing?
Well, talking points. Last time I met this guy, I couldn't stop talking about his hometown. He's like 100% Texas through and through. Marcus. Hi, Sam Chow.
Hey, how have you been?
It's good to see you again. Sorry I'm late. I just flew in from New York this morning. I'm just kind of...
Huh?
Can I get you some coffee or... There's coffee in China, right, Fang Fang?
We have decaf, dark roast, French roast, low-fat milk, full-fat milk, soy milk, sugar, honey, and artificial sweetener.
Wow.
Some hot tea would be wonderful.
Well, looks like I kept you waiting.
Oh, don't sweat it. I carry my brushes with me wherever I go so I can practice my Chinese calligraphy. Mm. Ever since relocating to Shanghai, I've just fallen in love with Chinese culture.
I know what you mean. I really treasure my heritage. There's leaves in my tea.
That's how I drink it.
Mm. Delicious. Mm.
Oh, yeah. This is, fragrant. Mm. So, Marcus, what can I help you with today?
What's the biggest complaint people have about touchscreen phones? They're too hard to type on. Mm. You can't feel the keys, so you make way too many typos, right? Not anymore. Give this baby a try.
Wow. That is impressive. Look at that. I can actually see you right through that. Wow. That is incredible. I can actually feel my fingers touching the screen. How did you do that?
Using a substrate that's attracted to the charge of human skin. The inventor's a genius, a Chinese guy named Yu Baiyang. Total recluse. Disappears for months at a time and then pops up with a gadget that changes everything. Huh. But he's a creative type, so he usually sells the product to the first person who finds him. I found him. Now I need you to draw up a purchase agreement before anybody else finds out about this phone.
I wouldn't recommend that. No, I mean, it's simply because purchase agreements can take a long time to close. You have to deal with copyrights and trademarks, and you have to also verify patents. I mean, what you want, ideally, is a license agreement. It's faster. And if the inventor isn't too experienced in contracts, I can get you that phone for a fraction of the price. Say the phone's worth $50 million. We license it for $5 million. The inventor keeps all the patents, and you start producing the phones right away. If it's a hit, everyone makes money. But what if it's a flop? See, that's okay too, because we minimized your risk. You didn't buy the phones for $50 million, you licensed it for $5 million.
So by going this route...
Whoa, hold up. So I saved myself $45 million and I still get the phone?
You sure he's gonna go for this?
Absolutely.
All right. Let's do it. Well, Sam, I'm sure glad that you're the one in charge here.
Thank you.
All right. I'll call you.
Speak soon. What the hell was that? You second-guess me in front of a client back there? A huge client. Don't ever do it again. Understood?
Sam, I'm only trying to help.
Oh, hello. I'm Guang, the computer specialist. I work with Fang Fang.
We're talking about things.
但是你说如果有国际长途电话来的话，要来找你。
谢谢。 Hello, Paul and Davis. It's Joey from New York.
Hey, is this seat taken? Thought my girl problems were supposed to be over, right?
Don't be so hard on yourself, man. We all have our dry spells.
You don't get it, dude. My whole life has been a dry spell. That's why I moved here. But just before I showed up, word finally got around that English teachers only came here to get laid.
There you are. I've been looking all over for you. I see you met Brad, so lay it on me. What do you think of China so far?
It's interesting. Sorry, my brain's a little fried. I haven't slept a wink since I got in.
Been there. Don't worry. This is gonna be the best move you ever made.
Well, we will see what happens after I get home.
Home is for suckers. Let me tell you a story. A while back, a fry cook from Louisville applies to the exec program at JFC. He got in, but he was considered a joke. Then the company opened up shop in China. Nobody wanted to go, so he volunteered. 20 years later, he's the third highest paid exec in the company and the mayor of America Town. This is the new land of opportunity, Sam.
Hi there, nice to meet you. This is Amanda, she's single.
Hi, yeah, I'll be right there.
Excuse me.
Friend's rather direct, isn't she?
Yeah.
I'm Chase.
Amanda, hi.
Hi. So how long have you been in Shanghai, Amanda?
4 years, but these bars are not my normal hangout.
No, mine neither. I teach at a rural school, so I don't get into town very often.
Oh.
So, what do you do?
Relocation specialist. I help foreign employees find places to live when their companies send them.
Gorgeous.
It keeps me busy. Especially if the client has a family, I help get their kids enrolled in the international school.
Hey,
so there's...
you're really beautiful, do you know that?
Yeah, that's totally acceptable. Pretty Chinese girl.
Oh, where?
Anywhere you look.
Amanda!
Brad. Sam? Where's Donald? Thought he was showing you off tonight.
He was, until he got called up to the dance floor.
So, Sam, how's the apartment?
It's quiet. I told you my idea would work.
Right, I'm not sure that it did. They actually kind of laughed when I told them about your lawsuit threat.
It really pains you to admit that I was right. Is that it?
Hey. Another cute guy for you.
He's only 22. Let's go.
So Amanda, she's single, right? I thought she had a kid.
Divorced. Moved here right after the split. Now that her kid's a little older, her friends are trying to get her back in the dating scene.
Huh.
No. You do not go there. You don't come to China to meet white girls. You're into Chinese girls, right?
I don't know, man. I never dated one.
Bro, you are all messed up, bro. It's time you got in touch with your culture by having sex with it. Dude, you're in China. Now have some baijiu. Gumby!
You know, China's gonna be a great place once it's finished.
Why are you here?
You passed out at the bar last night, so I had to drag your ass back home. I was gonna crash on your sofa, but your bed just looks so comfortable.
You want some breakfast?
I know a great steam bun place near here. Oh.
两个.
God damn, that is a delicious baozi.
What kind of meat is this again?
Snake. Ah, gotcha, it's pork. It's pork. Seriously, you gotta try snake sometime, it's good.
I'll be sure to never do that. Hey man, thanks for making sure I got back in one piece last night.
No problem. I'm gonna get some more baozi.
Okay. Hello?
Sam?
Marcus Groff.
Hey, Marcus.
No, I'm actually not in the office just yet. I should...
Yeah. We got a problem.
You buy Yang, the inventor?
He signed my license agreement a few days ago.
And then he signed another license agreement with some local manufacturer.
Whoa, Marcus, wait, relax. He can't do that. There's no possible way he can do it. Why would he even...
How the hell should I know? He probably figured out what a raw deal you gave him. Now somebody else is making my phone.
Marcus?
This was supposed to be safe, Sam.
Marcus, calm down. Listen to me. This is totally safe. That contract is ironclad. There's absolutely no way that he can license those phones to another manufacturer. But if that's what he's trying to do, we still have plenty of time to stop whatever deal he thinks.
Check out what I just bought. It's a touchscreen phone you can actually feel the keys on. I can type so fast on this thing. See that? I can type so fast on this thing, as fast as I said it.
Marcus, I'll call you back.
I just typed it again.
Where'd you get that?
At a big cell phone store in the corner, but it looks like they're selling them here, too.
Where did you get this? This phone, where did you get this phone?
I know. 这个电话是我们公司新进的产品，非常的酷，您可以试一下。哎，先生，我觉得这个手机特别适合您。Whoa,
are we running? Do we need to run?
No, I bought them all. Just grab the rest. Taxi! Come on. Pop this truck, please. Thank you.
I really love this phone, huh?
No. Brad, this is my client's phone. Somebody else is making them. How the hell did they get in these stores so fast?
Haven't you heard? The Chinese are really good at manufacturing, dude.
Brad, I need to get these phones off the street ASAP. I need you to go to every store that is selling these phones and buy them up. Here, I'll give you my corporate card.
I got an English class to teach.
Damn it. All right, I'll call my assistant.
Whoa, hang on. I could be persuaded to skip my English class if the right motivation was there.
You want me to bribe you?
No.
Fine, I will hire you as a local consultant for the firm. Huh? How's that?
Deal. I'll get right on it.
Take the card.
What are you gonna do?
How the hell could you let this happen?
This is not my fault, sir.
Groff was planning to put that touchscreen into every phone, laptop, and tablet he makes. Now someone else is gonna beat him to it because you got fancy with the contracts?
I didn't...
If he sues us for negligence, we're looking at billions in damages. Billions.
Fix it, Sam. You fix this, or I will make sure this stink follows you for the rest of your sorry career. Do I make myself clear?
Absolutely, sir. I assure you this will be taken care of very quickly. I'm talking lightning speed here. This is... It's fixed. Hello? Hello?
Look,
我们很多人下了班去吃塔巴斯餐厅，我吃过一次塔巴斯，在世博会上，有点像早茶点，但是西班牙的。哎，你应该吃过很多菜系吧？你跟你爸出了那么多次国。
Nice place.
Thanks.
Is that Warren Buffett?
Sure is. Showed him around back in 95.
Mm. Wish I could have been there. I mean, I was just in grade school at the time. Esther Wu, Klein Motors. I'm
running against me for AmCham presidency. Thanks for volunteering. You know, the election committee always has a hard time finding someone to run against me.
Mm. Is that so? I should have come to Shanghai a little sooner then. Shanghai isn't a hardship post for outcasts anymore. It's a gold star on your resume, and it's attracting the best and brightest these days. Rhodes Scholars, MBAs. They're the new face of the expat community. And they want an AmCham president who shares their background. Instead of one who
took a dying American brand and turned it into the biggest restaurant chain in China. Sam the lawyer. How's business? Figured out what to do about that phone manufacturer yet?
Heard about that.
I hear everything. After all, I am the mayor. Now let's deal with your little mess. Call this fella. He's a problem solver. Helps guys like you out all the time. Call him Awesome Wang. Freelance reporter. Kind of guy with a real nose for digging up hard-to-find facts and nailing the bad guys.
No.
What's the matter?
I have a $1 billion legal mess on my hands right now, and you want me to call a guy named Awesome Wang. How's that gonna look on my expense report?
You young bucks always think you know everything.
Awesome Wang? It's ridiculous. No, the meeting is only with Mr. Lin, the other manufacturer. Apparently, Yu Baiyang is out finding some sort of inspiration or something. I don't know. Don't worry, Marcus. I will straighten everything out. I promise. Okay? Hi.
The research material you wanted.
Can I get you a drink or something?
No, thanks. Wow, this is a nice place.
Yeah.
You live here by yourself?
It's my roommate. So, something on your mind?
I know that your bosses were pretty harsh on you today. I want you to know that
Amanda, hi, it's Sam. I think you were right about the construction workers. So the backup apartment you mentioned,
Okay, well, we'll tell the manager we'll be in the neighborhood, and whenever he's free, yeah, I can pick you up. Where do you live?
Are you hungry, Katie? You want a snack? What do you want to eat?
你想吃什么？我想去云南路吃豆浆油条。
Did you see that?
Relax, at least she's speaking again.
Yeah, only in Chinese. I guess that rules out a whole hearing problem thing, but...
You're really crazy, do you know that?
Oh, God. I wish I'd scheduled Sam for tomorrow.
You should have told him to go find his own apartment.
Oh, right. What was I supposed to do, just drop him after he apologized to me?
Uh-huh.
I'm fighting for business as it is. The last thing I need is somebody out there spreading bad word of mouth, and we all know the most difficult clients have the biggest mouths. Sam! You are punctual.
Yeah, well, your door was open.
Hi. Hey, Sam.
Good to see you again.
Good luck with your apartment search.
Thanks. Oh, I feel like I'm back in the States here.
Yeah, we make it work. Speaking of we, Sam, this is Katie. Katie, say hi to Sam.
叔叔好。
She stopped speaking English. I have no idea why.
妈妈,我可以出去玩吗?
当然可以。
Hey, Katie. Wow. That is a really cool shovel. What's it for? Is it a secret? Yeah, I bet it is. How about this? I'll tell you a really cool and really funny secret of mine if you tell me what the shovel's for. There's this one there. What is it? I think that's pretty funny, huh? So what's the shovel for?
I'm digging a hole to America.
What did you just say? No, come on, seriously, what did you just say to her?
It's an attorney-client privilege thing. I shouldn't.
Is that how you want to play it? Real cute. Okay, look, I gotta ask, what did you say to Katie back at the house? I mean, she's not said one word of English in over a week, and no offense, but you're kind of the last person in the world I expected to have away with kids. So why did she... Never mind.
No, I'm listening. Go ahead, sorry.
Really, what I just say?
I'm sorry, I'm not listening. No, it's just that I'm kind of dealing with this, like, career-ending crisis at work, and it's just really...
Sounds serious.
Yeah.
You know, if you need help, there's a guy you could call. Awesome Wong. He's a Shanghai hero. He helps people out of trouble all the time.
Right, so I've heard. Mm-hmm. Hey, listen, are you hungry? Can I buy you lunch? While we're waiting for the manager to call? My treat? Help me make up for that little temper tantrum I threw the other day.
Okay.
Ah, 这里面还是外面？里面，谢谢。这边，谢谢。
Thank you. Why does she keep giving?
Because I obviously don't speak Chinese, and you obviously do.
Right.
Happens all the time. Here, take my menu. It's in English.
I gotta learn this stuff. So how does a girl like you get to be such an expert on China?
Well, I took 3 years of Mandarin in college and studied at Beijing University for a semester. I even spent summers working at a Chinese restaurant in Nebraska, you know, keep up my language skills. Customers got a real kick out of me.
I bet.
Mm-hmm.
So is that why you moved here with Katie after the...
Yeah, Katie's dad wasn't exactly father of the year material, so after we split, I decided to get away from him as far as possible.
Yeah, this would pretty much do it.
I know, but I knew the language, and growing up here will open up all sorts of job opportunities for Katie, so made sense.
One of those moms, huh?
Guilty. So, let me guess, you only moved here because someone offered you a big promotion. I've seen your type before.
My type? I'm sorry, what is my type?
No, I have said way too much already.
No, I won't get mad, you can tell me, I can take it. What is my type?
Okay. Slick businessman, charming, driven, You come here to do business, but you still want to be perceived as an American company, so you downplay your association with China as much as you can. In fact, you downplay it so much that nobody thinks about the actual human beings who make your product. Until, of course, something awful happens and it winds up all over the news. So you make a few changes, hope that your customers have a short memory, or if you're a real jerk, you just pretend you had no idea what was happening in your own factory and blame everything on the Chinese.
I know this story. I think I do. Corporations are evil, and we don't care about people, right? What about the jobs we create? Technology transfer from building plants here, no credit for that, nothing.
Oh, please, that's not charity work. It's another way for you to make money.
Amanda, do you know how many designer shops and luxury car dealerships I passed today on the way over here? Trust me, the Chinese are making plenty of money.
Yes, international trade has definitely improved the quality of life here, but it's a side effect. Foreign businessmen don't come here to contribute to Chinese society. They come here to profit from it.
I'm contributing.
Okay, how?
By practicing law. My client is just like you. He loves China. He wants to take a Chinese inventor's product and turn it into the biggest thing in the world, and he needs my help to do that. You understand this? That's what I do. I help people.
Whatever you say.
All right. How about this? You come by my office. Watch how I'm going to fix this little hiccup with my client, get him back on the road to doing business here. Then you'll see what I mean.
We'll see.
我刚去完美发沙龙，头发一团糟。你能借我一个发卡吗？我包里好像有一个，你看看吧。你现在用这个颜色啊？这个好像更适合晚上用吧。你这个有钱人家的姑娘不会分不清日妆和晚妆的区别吧？
啊，谢谢你的发卡。你是我的雨衣，包裹我的身体，不管刮风下雨，你总包围着我。
怎么这么晚了？哎呀，你就别数他了，你知道他的工作是很累人的。哎，我今天发工资了，咱们去吃饺子吧。哦，上哪儿去吃啊？这东风饭店刚被拆了。哎呦，别再抱怨了。你看，今天晚饭不都已经有了吗？芳芳，来，这是什么饭啊
？Empanadas， 有点像饺子，但是西班牙的。来。
谢谢啊，不客气。你在这干嘛？你上次没有跟我们一起去吃
tapas，
所以我带回来给你吃了。哎，我……哦，没事，我们客气。我是在资源数据库找到你的地址的。我开门的时候啊，他很吃惊。芳芳啊，你是不是没有跟你的同事说你是跟父母一起住的？还有婆婆呢。
啊，婆婆，你别建议。
我啊，我上大学的时候没有告诉任何人我跟我父母一起住，像你这么优秀的小伙子啊，都这么做了，我们呢，该原谅芳芳。来，该吃饭了。来，阿光，这边坐。哎，他留在这吃饭？
当然了，在等你回来的时候，我们谈得很好的。你知道，
他的老家也是江苏的吗？
老乡，
他不能留下。你这孩子。
对客人要有礼貌，我不太有礼貌啊。你不是说你今天有事吗？要跟那个谁谁谁去吃饭？嗯？
哦，对，阿姨。
真的对不起，真的对不起，我的婆婆对不起，叔叔对不起，我在浦东还有一件事要去办呢，对对对，几点了我都不知道，对，可能也堵车，我来不及了，这边是我把这个先留下来，好好好，我真的知道了。哎呦，很高兴认识大家，叔阿姨，下次见啊。宝宝，怎么回事啊你？
啊！嗯，decided to come by after all, huh?
Yeah, I was in the neighborhood. Yeah, I have some apartment photos I wanted to show you, so.
Yeah. Marcus, this is my colleague Amanda. She's going to be sitting in with us today.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on in.
Who's that woman?
She's my guest.
You shouldn't bring a guest to a meeting. It's unprofessional.
Mm. Thanks for your opinion.
这些老板什么都不懂。非常感谢啊，吃茶真香。
Wow, this must be Mr. Lin.
Yeah, looks like he brought some muscle.
看见了吗？不是只有你才请得起外国律师. Jensen studied law at Stanford.
Huh. You look familiar. I had a friend who went to Stanford Law, Joy Pritikin, you know him?
Let's just get to business, shall we?
All right. This mobile phone is intellectual property exclusively licensed to my client by Mr. Yu Baiyang. This identical mobile phone was manufactured by Mr. Lin in his factory, and we actually bought this just down the street here in a really cute little shop. So your client is clearly infringing on my client's rights.
No. No. This is not true. I'm the only one with permission to make Yu Baiyang's phone.
Oh.
Get them. Show them.
Mm. You realize that just because you have a signed contract doesn't make it valid. Yu Baiyang executed my client's agreement on the 18th of this month, and according to your contract, he executed yours on the 19th. And since an exclusive license agreement is singular by definition, the fact that ours is first in time renders yours completely void.
Impossible. It is impossible.
These contracts make no sense. In my opinion, we should do nothing until Yu Baiyang resurfaces to clear this up.
Is that what they taught you at Stanford Law? If Mr. Lin keeps his factory running, he'll be intentionally breaching my client's contract. The next phone call I make will be to file an injunction against him under PRC civil procedure law. So let's just keep this simple, Stanford. Either Mr. Lin stops making the phones, or we sue him for everything he's got.
I'm advising my client to stop his operation.
There's no need to sue.
Sam Chow, there is no substitute.
I told you not to worry.
How about this guy?
So what'd you think?
I think you're born to be a lawyer.
Oh, come on. I just got my client back on the road to doing business here in China, and it was very easy since Lin's attorney was not too well-versed in trade law. My point is this. I stood up for justice back there.
Ah, you're a superhero.
What?
I'm just trying to figure out which is the real you. The nice guy who made my daughter feel completely at ease, or the carpetbagger who honestly thinks he just helped someone.
I did just help someone.
And that clinches it.
Uh-huh.
Catch me, that piece of rubbish bicycle.
The spinning class 3 times a week, bitch. Why the hell were you in that JFC commercial? Are you a lawyer or not?
Yes, of course I'm a lawyer.
Stop lying to me. Who the hell are you?
I'm an actor, okay?
Actor? What do you mean, this whole meeting with Lin was fake?
Yes. He just wanted to get you off his back. Look out! Someone's stealing your briefcase!
The fake lawyer trick? I haven't seen that one in years. This guy Len must be old school. Sounds like the young buck's finally ready to listen to an old man's advice.
Hey, you.
Hey.
Fought any good battles for justice recently?
Haven't you heard? I'm only out for myself.
Oh.
Heading to a party?
More like a date.
Date? Wow. Some kind of angel for you to go out with him.
I wouldn't know. It's a blind date. Some French banker Natalie set me up with, don't ask.
You still want to know what I said to Katie?
What happened to attorney-client privilege?
She's a horrible client. Mm. Never pays her bills.
Mm-hmm.
Want to know or not?
Yes. What did you say?
With that, the only word I know how to say in Chinese is fangpi. Fart.
Yeah, no, I got it.
Yeah.
Okay, so how did that...
By letting her know she's not the only weirdo around. It's not easy growing up in a place where nobody looks like you.
Uh-huh.
And kids, they just want to fit in. And all the other kids, they only speak Chinese. So, how do you think I wound up speaking only English?
Why didn't you tell me that earlier?
Because it was obvious, Al.
Oh, walk it off. So where are you headed anyway?
I'm heading to meet the legendary Awesome Wang.
I thought you had that all figured out.
I thought I did too, but it just seems like every time I turn around, that the rug just keeps getting pulled out from under me, and feels like everyone is out to get me.
You really shouldn't talk about your people that way.
Look, it's like I am totally out of my element here. That lawyer from yesterday, not a lawyer. Taxi drivers don't understand a word I'm saying. Oh, and I just found out about the business card thing. I go to a meeting, I'm supposed to hand him my business card, and apparently, you're supposed to use 2 hands and bow at the same time. And I know it's a little thing, but I'm used to doing things my way, so I have to think about it. And if I have to think about every single little thing, it's,
Yeah, sounds like someone's going expat crazy. At least you know how your parents felt. They were immigrants, right? Okay, well, at some point, they upped and moved to another country for better jobs and a better life, and they figured it out. We Americans like to call ourselves expats, but the fact of the matter is we're immigrants. This is my stop. Good luck.
Thanks.
Good luck to you, too.
Sam? 我是王给力。 进去说吧。
这个外号啊，比外面打着给力的幌子卖小商品的小贩儿可早多了。
Tell me, what you need to help with?
Donald said that you're great at finding people. So there's this manufacturer. His name is Lin. He's violating my client's product license agreement. So I met with Lin, and he. I'm meeting with Lin and his lawyer, but his lawyer turns out to be some actor. He turns out to be a British actor. His name is Jensen. And now I can't find Lin anywhere. Hey, excuse me. Can we just put this in a place a little more private? I feel like privacy's an issue.
Anybody here understand this guy?
I think you are okay.
So anyway, I can't find Lin anywhere, and I have Jensen's phone number. He was in a JFC ad, so Donald helped me get this. I was gonna give him a call, but...
My daughter, she's two.
She's adorable. It's very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet all of you. Found Jason.
大活人不能让尿憋死。在门口等我啊，我去开车。
What is this place?
KTV.
What?
KTV? 你没来过 KTV 啊? KTV is English.
Nope.
我有一只小毛驴，我从来也不骑。卡拉 OK.
Are you saying karaoke? So how are we supposed to find him? This place is huge.
Hello, Jason. This is Wang Geili.
The reporter who texted you earlier.
Right. Sorry, mate. I've changed my mind about doing that interview.
You don't say. May I ask why?
Honestly, there's this wanker I'm trying to avoid.
Uh-huh, interesting.
But he's some lawyer from the States.
Oh, from the States?
I don't need him seeing my name and photo all over the place. press anytime soon.
Oh, that's too bad. Your story is interesting. I still want to talk to you.
But it is interesting. Yeah, well, thank you. I can't right now. But if you're still looking to interview a foreign actor in a few weeks' time, then give me a call then, and I'd be happy. Okay? See you later.
Goodbye.
Wow, you are an actor, a lawyer, and a singer. That is really impressive. Where's Lynn?
Do we have to do this here?
Yes, we do.
I don't know where he is.
All right, buddy, look. My reporter friend here works for some very widely read newspapers in Shanghai, so unless you want everyone to know,
hey.
I mean everyone.
He's actually come back.
What?
Fang Fang?
You know her?
She's my assistant.
You don't say. 祝贺你找到新的工作.
What the hell are you doing here?
你三通我告诉我伊拉克达，我哪能晓得？你是侬老伯啊？现在哪能办啊？随便编啥么子，帮伊讲。讲啥呢？随便编侬会伐？They're
about to lie to you, buddy.
Shut up!
Jason， 我刚才这个朋友说的都是实话。我是一个新闻记者，那这是有新闻价值的案子，我要采访这个林先生。 但如果我找不到他，那我只好把你的名字写在报道当中了。当然，我知道像你这么一位努力上进的演员，你是不愿意玩这种游戏的，对不对？嗯。
700 Dagulu, apartment 1804. That's where he lives.
So, working at a nightclub, huh? How long has that been going on? Having trouble understanding me tonight, is that what it is? You can't really understand what I'm saying? Is that it? Am I speaking too fast or too slow? Damn it, Fang Fang, I'm your boss. If I ask you a question regarding your employment status, you have to answer me. Do you understand that? How long have you had a second job?
Waitressing is not my second job.
Oh, great, so now you're lying to me.
It's my first job. Working for you is my second job.
What are you talking about? I thought your parents were rich or something.
My father is a construction worker. My mom cleans houses. When I was hired at your firm, I thought I could quit the nightclub. But living in Shanghai is so much pressure. Every woman with an office job has to have designer clothes and nice jewelries and Italian handbags. So I pretend to have wealthy parents and kept my other job just to pay for nice things. Okay?
Well, I guess that explains all the flirting.
Flirting?
Come on. You have been making eyes at me since the day I arrived. You came to my house. You got upset when Amanda showed up at the meeting. You just think I'm going to take you right back to New York with me, don't you?
I tell you my secret, and you accuse me of this. I want you to succeed in this job and act professional so the office stays open and I could go to law school and take care of my family. You're just... You don't understand anything. Screw you, Sam. I quit.
Talk about it. You find Lynn or not?
还不知道。保安不让我进去。
Couldn't get in? Awesome, I told you that uniform sucks.
Come on, it's not a big deal.
No, stay the hell away from me.
Amanda, what's going on?
My date? He's married. He's not looking for a relationship. He's looking to cheat on his wife.
No. It's not what you think it is. I love my wife very much.
Then why are you on a date with me?
Because I promised her I wouldn't have an affair with a Chinese woman.
Seriously? That's your reasoning?
Yes. Look, I'm a man living thousands of kilometers away from his wife. I have needs.
Oh.
Hey, so do you, yes.
Hey, buddy, she's not interested. Why don't you back off?
Oh, what?
Walk away.
Whatever.
You okay?
Yeah, I just...
What's the matter?
Do you know why people hire me? Because they see a single mom getting by in Shanghai and they think now they're someone who has her act together.
You do?
No, I don't. I live in a house I can barely afford. I wake up in the middle of the night wondering who will take care of Katie if something were to happen to me. I mean, it'd be great to not have to do this on my own, but every time I go on a date, it's that.
Well, I guess that makes you a duck.
What?
My mom used to say that certain people were like ducks because they make everything look easy. Out there in the water, like they don't have a care in the world, but if you look below the surface, you can see how hard their lives really are. Just paddling their little asses off, just, I mean, just like that.
You know that's a Chinese saying, right? The duck thing?
I think that's American.
Oh, okay. Who knows more about ducks? They eat millions of them in Beijing.
Good point. Huh. That must be more Chinese than I thought. Come on.
Thanks.
Okay, let me make it up to you.
No way.
But...
No buts. I'm done with expat guys. Okay, they've either got an Asian fetish or they're...
Turkey vultures? That's what my friend calls them, because they hover around waiting to pick the discarded white meat.
Oh, God.
Oh, 这怎么这么痛啊? 那是您的胃。
Told you not to eat before foot massage.
She can feel everything. Okay, now... Explain to me what Sam had to do with this.
Sam's the one who chased Philip away.
How?
By doing that thing guys do when they're about to fight, and then out of nowhere, he just kissed me.
Who? Philip?
No, Sam. Why would I let Philip kiss me?
I don't know. Why would you let Sam kiss you?
I didn't. No. Stop it.
He kissed you after defending your honor.
No.
Oh, my God. I knew he liked you.
We're nothing alike.
Exactly. Opposites. Like yin yang. You know, you're warm. He's fierce. You're easygoing. He's driven. You're Chinese. He's American.
You know what else? I live here. He's a short-termer. The second his job's done, he's going home.
Maybe he'll change his plans. For God's sake, he gets along with Katie. You need some romance in your life.
No, I'm done with romance. I was doing just how la nar tai tang la.
那是他的什么穴啊?
Oh, 这是他的心.
Okay. Or maybe I just have sore feet. Anybody ever considered that?
Just a reminder, we've got a meet and greet with Commerce Secretary Whitson on the evening of the 29th.
It is the 29th, right?
Yeah.
Good. Going to be in town for some meetings and some photo ops, so if anyone's got any gripes about trade subsidies, this is your chance to have some face time with the man. I'm talking to you, Janet.
I love you too, Donald.
Now it's time to turn things over to Ted Holmby, who's got this year's AM.
Is this seat taken?
No, please sit.
I didn't know you were coming to this thing.
Yeah. And Donald called me this morning, and I thought I should come show my support. And...
Same.
Yeah.
It was closest election, they said, in years.
Yeah. Yep.
So.
Close.
So how'd it go with Awesome Wong?
I may just dig myself out of this hole. I'm just waiting for him to call.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. So how'd it go with the French guy?
Philip?
Yeah.
Yeah, no more trouble. I think you scared him off pretty good.
Good. Not that scaring people is a good thing. I'm glad you're okay.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, if I overstepped any boundaries last night...
So 3 months, is that set in stone? Because, you know, sometimes people stay longer.
Maybe. I mean, I could see myself staying a little bit longer.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow. Thank you.
Wait, what just happened?
Mr. Wu is the new mayor of America Town.
Thank you. Thank you very much. This is such a surprise. I was not expecting this at all. Thank you so much. This is a great day.
Donald! 48%.
That's it?
Yeah.
Thought everyone loved him.
They do, or they did. And I guess the times are finally catching up with him. I should go check on him, see if I can get the mayor of Canada Town to come cheer him up.
That's a good idea.
I have tickets to this American Film Festival next week. I mean, I'm pretty sure all the films are in English, but I didn't know if maybe you weren't too busy, if you'd want to go.
It's awesome.
Oh.
I mean, it's awesome, Wang. He's calling me. I gotta...
Right. No, yeah. Dig yourself out of that hole.
But the movie, that sounds awesome, too. So I'll call you, okay?
Yeah, do that. That'd be awesome.
Okay. Hey, did you find him?
没，但我已经进了公寓楼了。
English awesome. I can't see you. You have to speak English.
I got into the building. It does not seem like the kind of place where a sneaky businessman would live.
Great, so Jensen lied about the address.
Orlin is not who we think he is.
Are you sure of the facts now?
He had an actor pose as his lawyer, awesome. That's all I need to know.
So what the hell do we do now?
Sorry, I'm out of ideas.
I know, Brad. I get it.
Mr. Zhao, New York is starting video call soon.
Can I help you, Guang?
Fang Fang quit because she loved you, and you broke her heart. You chose that American woman instead. You are a rotten radish.
What?
花心大萝卜. It's not funny.
Please tell me you're opening an electronics store.
No, sir, I am not. These are the phones that Lin is producing. I've been going around buying as many as I could find to keep them off the street.
This is not good, Sam. Not good for the firm and certainly not for you. Get on the first flight back to New York. We need to have a face-to-face discussion about your future.
Maybe you should go on a vacation.
I hate vacations.
Okay, we'll make it exciting. How about a safari?
Oh, you should go to Bangkok. I know this really hot masseuse there. Her name's Kevin.
This doesn't look good.
It's not. I got called back to New York.
You leaving already?
Yeah, my flight's in a few hours. I thought I should come by and say goodbye before I left. Amanda, can I talk to you for a minute in private? Donald.
Good luck. What's your back?
I really was thinking about staying.
Sure you were.
I'm sorry. Look, I'm gonna go back to New York, and
And what? You knew exactly what I was asking you the other night. Why didn't you just tell me the truth?
I swear I didn't know I was leaving.
I did. Sooner or later, you were always going home.
You seem troubled. May I ask why?
It's complicated. I came here to China because I thought it would help my career, and now my career is over. So thanks for everything, China. Sarcastic to you.
I judge not. Surely there was something you enjoyed during your stay here.
Yeah, there was, but she's pissed at me.
A woman, huh?
Yeah. Not exactly your area of expertise, I'm guessing. Right. Well, anyway, there's no use in obsessing over it. I'm never going to see her again, so.
One never knows what the future holds.
I know. Trust me, I know.
You see this bean here? It was once just a pit of a small berry. Left undisturbed, it would have remained so. But being plucked from its shell, it scorched in flame, crushed into powder and boiling water, it transforms this into something far more delicious and far more meaningful than just a mere pit.
A little confused about everything you just said. Am I the coffee bean? Is that what you're... Am I the pit? Am I the pit? I gotta get burned and boiled and all that stuff before I can become the bean? Is that it? Okay, listen, I've been through all that. I've been boiled, I've been burned, I lost my job, and I lost the girl. And after all that, I'm still a pit. Wait a minute. That's it. Amanda. Thank you so much. Thank you.
I feel like I should give you a donation or something.
A donation?
Yeah, because you're a monk.
Why do all Americans think I'm a monk? I just enjoy wearing robes and giving advice. Not all bald men in China is a monk, you know?
No. Whatever it is, I'm not helping you.
All I have is Lynn's home address. If you could just look through your real estate database...
You're not my client anymore.
Then I'm here to hire you. No, I am. I want to buy Lynn's apartment. It's a pretty nice place, and I can't contact him without his phone number, right? Come on. Man, I'm sorry. I'm trying to become a coffee bean here, and this...
What?
I don't know. Never mind. Look, I admit it, okay? I only came here to make partner. Because I was...
A selfish prick who will step on anyone to get what he wants?
Take it easy. My point is that I don't want to be that guy anymore. And proving that to you is going to take more than the 3 hours that I have left before my flight takes off. Please, just help me find this guy. It's my only shot at buying a little more time here with you.
Give me the address. No, I mean, come inside. Okay, Lynn. I am not seeing any phone numbers, but it looks like he recently sold some properties around town.
All right, well, leave the lead. I'll check it out.
Wait, hang on. There's something else. He also just bought a commercial property in Changzhou.
What is that, like a neighborhood or something?
No, it's an industrial town outside of Shanghai.
Are there factories there?
Yeah, lots. In fact, it looks like this one that he owns is a factory. Do you think?
Yes. I do. That's it. That's where it's making the phones. And you found it. You are a lifesaver.
Would you stop doing that?
Okay, I'm sorry. He's very excited.
Just go. Find Lynn, okay? And give me time to think.
Hello.
Donald, hey, it's Sam. Listen, I know where Lynn's factory is, okay? Apparently, he owns some industrial property in a place called Chanzhou.
Hangzhou.
Right, whatever they just said. Listen.
I think I can still salvage this thing, but I need your help. How do I file an injunction against the factory?
Changzhou's in the Jiangsu province. You need to file a complaint with the Jiangsu Administration of Industry and Commerce.
Okay.
Make an appointment, plead your case, and convince them to get a magistrate out there to shut the plant down. It might take a couple of weeks.
A couple of weeks? I don't have a couple of weeks. There has to be a faster way here.
Not unless you have some guanxi with the Jiangsu AIC.
How am I going to get that?
I have a cousin that works there.
Donald, I'll call you back. You have a cousin, Guang? Are you serious? Listen, man, you've just made my day. Please call him for me.
The flowers are dying.
Forget about the flowers. We're talking about cousins here. Can you please call him for me?
I don't know. I'm still upset with you for toying with Fang Fang's heart.
I didn't toy with Fang Fang's heart. There's nothing going on between me and Fang Fang, okay? She was pissed at me because I was a jerk, and that's why she quit. That's the truth. Now, please, call your cousin for me. I am desperate.
How desperate?
怎么了?
Hi, my name's Sam. I'm looking for Fang Fang.
Oh, 我听不懂.
I work with her. I'm her boss, actually. Business card.
Oh, 很结实。哦。All right。结婚了没？妈。人家是来找他妈谈工作的。妈，来来来，别影响别人，别影响工作。What
do you want?
I'm sorry for insulting you the other day. It was condescending and rude. I was way out of line.
Yeah, right. What do you want?
I want you to go on a date with Guang.
You crazy?
Please, Fang Fang, I'll give you anything you want.
Anything.
Anything.
Have me back.
Done. That's done.
Help me with my law school entrance exam.
Help you with your law school entrance exam. Absolutely. I will help you. Now, will you just please go on a date with Quan?
Sam. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Shushu, 你好. 阿姨好. 婆婆你好. 萌萌.
你好，很高兴你能回来跟我们一起工作。公司里没有你真的很无聊。还要谢谢你呢，张的老板把我雇回来了。光，你是一个好人，你不应该和我在一起的。不，我要和你在一起。 从我们开始工作的第一天，你在咖啡机前对我笑的第一次，我就爱上了你。可是我不是像你想象那样的。你是我想象那样的，你聪明，你善良，你又漂亮，你也孝顺，你有一个很好的家庭。婆婆，我说的对吗？对对对。芳芳，我说的话里面。
Whatever he said right there, I'm sure is really romantic. How about if Fan Fan just one day?
Just
I'm telling you. So, Fan Fan is faxing the contract evidence to Jiangsu AIC as we speak. So, assuming everything is in order, they're sending a magistrate to the factory.
Sounds like you got this all wrapped up.
Oh, guess who just drove here in his new ride, bitches? I'm not just some horny English teacher anymore. I'm a horny English teacher with a car. You're still here.
Yes, and I might be for a bit longer, but I need a favor. Listen, I need a lift to Jiangsu. So how about we take this new ride of yours for a test drive?
Love to. Road trip!
我跟你们一起去。我想见见这位林先生。
He wants to come with.
Great, let's go.
我们快走吧。
现在你知道你的那些东西是怎么造出来的了吧？Mr.
Lin, wow, good to see you again. You look good. I have a magistrate here. He'd like to speak with you.
经工商局查证，你违反一项知识产权专营许可，勒令你立即停止生产。Please.
You can't do this. I spent all my family's money into this factory and produced this phone. I'll be bankrupt if you shut it down.
，全体注意，全体注意，老外他们刚关闭了我们的工厂，请工头到办公室来领取大家最后的工钱。
Yeah, dude. Mission accomplished.
The system worked?
Yeah. And Lynn's out of business.
And I am finally out of trouble. What is that noise?
The sound of trouble.
Again, Awesome with the janitor disguise. I told you this.
Listen, Lynn told the head worker to come and collect the severance pay. Only you two look like you might have it.
So I'll just tell him that we don't work with Lynn.
你显然是没有看见那个工头。
We don't work for Mr. Lynn.
I don't think he understands you, dude.
Yes, I can see that, Brad. What do we do?
Run!
Yep. Thank you.
How'd it go?
Couple of hiccups.
Mm-hmm.
But, we did it.
Yeah?
Yeah. And I'm glad you're here. You can see the new me. Did you get a hold of Marcus Groff?
Yes. Actually, he just arrived.
But there's no place to sit down in there because of all the damn phones. But tell me why I shouldn't have your firm dismantled and sold for scrap this very instant.
Because I fixed everything. Lynn's factory's been shut down, Marcus.
It has?
Yes, and I want you to know that I take full responsibility for all of this, and if anyone should take the fall, it should be me, not the people at the firm, and not these wonderful people here at the Shanghai office. Just...
Don't sweat it, man. Well, this turned out better than I'd hoped.
How's that?
Lynn thinks his contract isn't any good. Plus, I get a shipping container full of phones he built on his own dime.
What do you mean, Lynn thinks his contract is no good? It is no good.
不对，合同是有效的。于柏阳先生，他就是你跟我提起的那个人吧？Wait
a second, is that 于柏阳?
对，我进了林先生的公寓以后，发现不对劲。You
said something didn't feel right when you went to Lynn's apartment.
然后我就找到了手机的设计者于柏阳先生。
Okay, so he went to find the inventor.
最后发现我们全都被骗了.
Your client lied to you, like, big time.
Mr. Yu, hello again.
I can see you're busy, no problem.
If I can just get you
to sign this contract we discussed.
About the phone.
手机啊，我卖了.
No, I promised my shareholders I had something big in the pipeline. I was gonna pay you a lot of money for it.
我对钱不感兴趣。这个送给你了，Sam。 Marcus Groff, we got a problem.
Marcus, is this true? Is Lynn innocent?
He's not innocent. He hired an actor to pose as his attorney.
Because he could not afford a real attorney after starting up his business.
I spent all my family's money into this factory. I'll be bankrupt if you shut it down.
What's done is done.
You lied to me, Marcus. You used me to cheat an innocent man out of a huge business deal. You realize that?
Relax. Groff Technologies is going to make $1 billion next year, and that means more business for your firm. Well, I'm going to send over a truck to pick up these phones, okay? It's nice working with you, Sam.
Bye.
Hello, Paul and Davis. One moment, please.
New York is calling to see why you didn't get on that plane.
What are you gonna tell him?
Don't think about it too hard, Sam. You know what to do.
Actually, I don't.
Marcus Groff's company pays your salary. He's one of our most valuable clients.
There are plenty of other clients out there. This guy, Lin, he can use representation.
Groff has the infrastructure and the resources to revolutionize the computing industry with this technology. And you want to side with a backyard operation like Lin? Sam, just remember which team you play for.
Which team is that exactly? You guys sent me over here because I'm Chinese. You wanted someone who could connect with the people. My people. And now you want me to screw one of them.
Oh, when the hell did you care who gets screwed? Sam, you know what Groff is worth to us. And we know what making partner would mean to you. So just give Groff the phones and everybody wins.
I met some pretty famous attorneys in law school. Guys I modeled my career after. And I'm pretty sure none of them would understand what I'm doing.
You are an honorable man.
No, I'm just a coffee bean.
Ready?
Yeah. I'll take that.
Sam often thought he might open his own law practice someday. But he never imagined the day would come so soon, or that his practice would be in Shanghai. This was not the ending I anticipated when I first met Sam. Here was an ambitious man who would do anything for his career. But when offered the job he wanted all along, he chose instead to do the right thing. Perhaps I shouldn't be so surprised. Shanghai is a city that is always changing. Why should the people who come to Shanghai be any different? You may learn to become a far more humble person. Become the person you always dreamed of being. Realize you've been chasing the wrong dream for far too long.
Nice car.
That the trip you never wanted to take has become the most rewarding journey of all.
Do you mind keeping an eye on her while I get your cake ready? Happy 30th birthday.
Still digging that hole to America, huh?
How do you say shovel again?
This was the story of an American named Sam, a good man who was loved by everyone he met in Shanghai. For real this time.
第一面相识第一天勾了我的魂太迷人的眼洗了我的神就好像触了电每天未眠为了见你一面看着手机等着你的电话 聊到天亮笑了又哭了每一段对话让我深深的爱上了这个他曾经在不同世界里面寄居如今在同一个世界里面相遇这种缘分又爱去继续抱着你的感觉实在不能言语感受每个细节的细节今夜将会是我最难忘的一夜只有你我能二人世界你是我生命中唯一的女主角
天堂没你在我日思夜想，梦中的你是我最漂亮的女神，现实的你是我最想要的女人，深深的疑问注入我的灵魂，只想紧抱你直到凌晨。真命天子遇上了花仙子，糖沾豆粉不开的过着日子，我们把幸福刻记在这首歌，有你是我最大的快乐。
51 shells ready, take one.
I am totally out of my element. That guy knows what I'm talking about.
Doesn't matter how angry she was, the fact that she's calling you now means she cares about you. I'm sorry.
Sorry, give you that serious face.
No, I said angry.
Leave me the charm too long.
Sorry, one more time.
Ever since relocating to Shanghai, I've really fallen in love with Chinese culture.
I know what you mean.
Here, let's do that again.
He wants to come with.
Great, more the merrier.
You run, you.
We gotta go.
Run, you will do your
hop. Take one. 好了。Take two. I do not need romance. I was doing just fine. Take three. I was doing just fine. Hola, hola.
No.
Would you stop doing that? Take two.
Hey, Daniel.
Yo.
Just grab her head.
Yeah. Let's show you her dresser.
Clean it up, Daniel.
Just grab her head, dude.
The research material you wanted.
The what?
Michael.
Hi.
The reason. 对不起.
Excuse me.
Give her the card again.
I'm so sorry. It's so embarrassing. Oh!
God. Damn, that is a delicious bouncer.
What part of me is this again?
这里永远是你的家。
One more.
Okay.
Sir, can I get some?
We have been looking at this menu for hours.
So, try to do that again.
What the am I doing?